HCAM TV Sports presents Hopkinton High School Hockey, where tonight the Hillers take on the Bellingham Blackhawks. Hi, everybody. Mike Prate with Mike Terosian. We're bringing you the action here on a Wednesday, January 6, 2015. 16, rather. There we go.
Yeah, I was waiting to see how long it would take.
And the Hillers come in with their record, Mike, of 6 wins, 1 loss. The last game HCAM did, we went down to a Holliston game where the Hillers ended up winning that game by the score of 5-1. And Mike, the game really wasn't that close. The Hillers dominated with their team speed and really put a lot of pressure on the goaltender for Holliston, Adam Campersall.
Yeah, Campersall did a great job defending the heat that was given by the Hillers. The Hillers spent, I would say, most of the time in their zone for the whole game, including defending a couple power plays.
Yeah, the shots on goal total in that game were Hillers had 45 and the Panthers had 13. One of the top reasons why Hopkinton is doing so well, they've got 12 points right now in 7 games, which is way ahead of the pace typically of most school teams.
Yeah, because we're halfway at the season now, right? This is just about a halfway mark.
Yeah, the Hillers, by the way, in that game had 5 different goal scorers. Karpinski, Koshev, Simos, Coveney, and Abbott all scored. One of the things I did want to bring up in the beginning, Mike, was Cam Finlayson, another 2 assists. And as in my mind, so far the games I've been to, he's been the best player on ice in every game that I've seen.
Yeah, doing a phenomenal job. And you know what? I love seeing the different lines doing well together as well. And I noticed a little, of course, I'm looking through a little view screen where you guys get to watch the whole game. You can see how they mixing up the lines and everyone's working together very well.
The Blackhawks from Bellingham come in with a record of 4-2, and they're no slouch of a team either. They were in a Rhode Island tournament with some tough customers, and they last played on December 29th, and that was in the Burville, Rhode Island Christmas tournament. They lost 6-5, but they have a couple of players on this squad that you got to watch out for. One of them is Nick Dulock. He's got 9 goals on the season and with a total of, and an assist there. So the Hillers are going to have to watch him. This Bellingham team has really come up, and they are coached this year again by Ken Bertone for the Blackhawks. We're all moments away from the player introductions and the national anthem. The Hillers are 4-1 now in the TVL. They, right now, as the list stands, they're in second place in the TVL.
But when was the last time you said that, Michael?
I'm happy that, you know, this, for all intents and purposes, this is going to be my last year doing these games.
Yeah,
and right now, the Hillers are on a good pace here to not only make the tournament, but maybe do a little bit of damage in the tournament. But tonight, though, they're up against the Bellingham team that always plays physical and always plays pretty well against Hopkinton. And so we are moments away from that team. The Hillers are led in goals, by the way. I just want to bring up a few stats by J.H. Volke. He's got 8. And then behind him with 5 is Will Abbott. Abbott leads the club with 11 points total, 5 goals and 6 assists on the season.
So it looks like we're going to miss the player introductions and go right into the national anthem.
All right, so we're going to let you listen to that. And
thank you.
right, the national anthem here at Navin Arena in Marlboro, Massachusetts. The goaltender for the Hillers tonight. Looks like it's going to be Dylan O'Leary. He's got a record of 3 wins, no losses. His save percentage is at a phenomenal rate. It's .97, so he's really had a solid season behind in the pipes for the Hillers, and he'll be matched up against Josh Morsch for the Panthers. He's got a goals against average, save percentage rather, of .85, so they're pretty close. So it should be a pretty good matchup tonight as the Hillers get ready to go against the Blackhawks. The Hillers will be skating from our left to right as we face the players' benches. And a face-off control by Everett Rolfe for the Hillers. Rolfe throws it up the sideboard, but he can't get it up past the Bellingham player. Bellingham pinches now, but it's defended now as Billy Allen takes it away, and he throws it up and does not get it out as Nick Dulock threw it back in for Bellingham. Here's Rolfe up the sideboard. It's hard to handle. Simos throws it up to the sideboard, but he can't get it out. Now Rolfe will go back and skate. Everett Rolfe up to Abbott. Abbott has it go through his hands. The Hillers cannot get the puck out. Now Simos will get at the center, and he has Finlayson who backhands it in, and the Hillers will make changes. Abbott with the puck. Now he's by himself. He spins. Now it's thrown to Lindquist. Lindquist takes a shot. It's a save. Off the blocker. Abbott went down hard there, and he's a little ginger here for the Hillers. The Hillers keep it in now, and now out to center it goes, and there to get it is Kyle Holland. He dumps it in, but the Hillers get it right back. Up ice it goes off the stick of Abbott. Abbott now still on the ice, a long shift. He gets to the circle, now spins again, takes a shot, and it's a save. And the goaltender, Josh Morse, will hang on. The Hillers are going to change a couple of defensemen. Pickens steps on. Will Pickens along with Zach Horgan. Faceoff won by Hopkins, but they can't control it. But they do get it back. Pickens now gains the red line, dumps it in deep, and the goaltender Moore stops it and leaves it for one of his players. Up the sideboard to Holland. Holland doesn't get it out now, and it goes down deep. And Vokey had it go underneath his stick, and it goes around the boards. Bellingham having trouble getting it out of the zone. One of the things we saw in the Holliston game, the Hiller speed getting to loose pucks was way better than the Panthers, and that's why they were successful. Horgan now throws it up off the sideboard. Lindquist has a rolling puck. He's trying to settle it down, but he's defended nicely, and now he gets it away. Chip to center and out. Here's Lindquist. He gets the red line, chips it down to the goal line, and Hills will change all five players. 13 minutes to go in the first period. We just started. There's no score. The turnover on the blue line now is Karpinski now throws it down deep to Saporosius. Saporosius now throws it, and he has it looking to set up. He keeps it on his stick, throws it in front, goes to the point to Allen. Allen avoids a man, takes a shot, and Morse gloves it and makes a save. Josh Morse, the senior goaltender.
I think you might just want to stick with the last thing.
Yeah, you know, that's...
throw that SH in there.
Yeah. Bad things might happen. Face-off won by the Hillers as Karpinski had a shot blocked, but it's now dumped down the length of the ice. It's going to be icing against the Blackhawks, and the Hillers will have another face-off inside the Blackhawk zone. Bellingham comes in with a record of 4 wins and 2 losses. They have only played one game in the TVL, so this is their second contest. And they did win that game, their one game in the TVL. They beat Ashland. There's a face-off, and there's a problem.
It's like a little equipment adjustment or a mouth cut.
Yeah, face-off control by Bellingham. They chip it, not out. That does out. It's a 2-on-1. Here's Dulock, the goal scorer. It's a shot. He gets it blocked. A good play. And up ice now, Koshev. He has a man. He has Karpinski. Saporosius. Saporosius to Karpinski. Shot and a save and a big save by Morse as he robbed a point-blank shot.
The speed has really increased. And I can tell you as a camera operator, Mike, it's going a little bit faster. officials talking to the Bellingham bench.
And the coaching staff over there is talking to them. All right, faceoff inside Blackhawk zone. The play has, for the most part, been inside the Bellingham zone. Cam Finlayson, oh, throws a nice pass for a shot, and a save by Morse. Another shot, and a save, another shot, and it's tied up. The referee can't see it, and a little chop there by Dulac on the back of Simos. Boy, the Hillers had a good spree right there where they, I believe, got three shots on goal in that sequence.
Yeah, it's nice when you can pick at the garbage.
And they, with 12-12 to go in the first period, there's no score. Faceoff won by the Hillers. Shot, it's a blocker save through traffic by Morse. There's another shot that goes wide, and the Hillers really putting pressure now on Bellingham. Bellingham cannot get. Simos now puts pressure on the puck. Steven Simos has his man, tips it away from him, and now Bellingham tries to go around the hard board, and they do, but their backfilling was Finlayson on the play. Delaney now throws it up, and Simos tips it in. There to get it is Cullen Day. Day throws it up, but he can't get it out. Now the Dulac will come and rescue a rolling puck. Dylan Boucher now loses the handle. Shot goes off of a Bellingham player into the netting for a stoppage of play. With 11:31 to go in the first period, the Hillers leading. There's no score. I looked at the one under period, and let's get a little bit ahead of myself. Right in the circle now for Hopkins, and Owen Delaney up against Jason Robideau. The win by the Hillers. And a shot, a backhander goes through the crease and wide. And the Hillers now putting pressure. Lindquist now throws it down. It goes under the stick of Delaney, but there to get it is Horgan. Now he chips it, but out to the center it goes, and the Hillers have two men back as Lindquist came back to defend. Chip up off the sideboard. And in the zone is Volke. Volke with a wrist and a glove save by Morse. Boy, when Volke gets that shot off, Mike, it's a blast.
It's got speed. It's got height. He likes going for the corners.
And it's another stoppage of play. The clock is stopping a lot here in this first period.
Yeah, and it's not because of penalties.
And it isn't. It's just because the Hillers are forcing Morse to make saves and stop play. All right, Saporosius now throws it across the crease. Allen comes down to fill a spot, and come back to fill his spot is Alex Koshev. But now Bellingham now looking to get out. They cannot get it out of the zone, and now they do tip it out. Into the zone comes Bellingham. There's a shot and a save, and it's in the goal. It went through O'Leary as he looked behind him, and Bellingham takes a 1-0 lead. But how about that? Hopkinton dominates pretty much. And there's an example, Michael. What happens when you just shoot the puck on goal? The puck went through O'Leary's pad. He looked behind him. And Bellingham takes a 1-0 lead.
Can't score if you don't shoot.
Wayne Gretzky said it.
I know it sounded familiar.
100% of the goals aren't scored if you don't shoot, or something to that effect. Yeah. All right, Hillers leading, trailing now 1-0. And a turnover at the neutral zone now, and Bellingham comes back in. Sean Williamson with a shot, and this time O'Leary gobbles it up for a stoppage of play. Well, Bellingham now getting a little life after that goal sneaking by. And Bellingham going into today has scored 30 times and given up 23 goals themselves. The Hillers have scored 33 times and only given up 13. There's a face. All right, two players are going to go to the penalty box. Finlayson's going to go, and Dulac is going to go, the two scoring people. And so it'll be 5-on-5 hockey.
Some words being given from the referee, and now the ref is saying something to the coach.
It'll stay 5-on-5 hockey. Both players will sit for a minute and 30. It's a shot and a save.
Bring off his pad. He couldn't glove it.
Yeah. And Bellingham now making some moves. Williamson throws it hard off the backboard for Bellingham. Now Bellingham now trying to put the puck out in front. They can't. And the Hillers now with some numbers will get out of the zone. Abbott chips it out the center. He tries to hit Karpinski. Karpinski tries to go around his man. It was defended nicely by Matt Alexander. Now it's an offside against Hopkinton. .9:59 to go in period number one. The Hillers trailing now 1-0. And a face-off controlled by nobody yet. Now Hopkinton will get it. Off the board and out it comes as Coveney dumped it out. And to center it comes. Good avoided check by Pickens. Bellingham and Nitrona trying to throw their body around, keep pressure on it. Now Lindquist comes away with it. Matt Lindquist gets the center. Here comes Vokey. Vokey, wrister, a shot that goes wide. Well, he gets that puck elevated. And now Bellingham, Hopkins is going to get a penalty as an interference penalty, definitely, is going to go against the Hillers. And to the box goes Will Pickens. So now Bellingham will go on a power play. And Hopkinton's going to have to kill. And a face-off won by Hopkinton. They launch it down the length of the ice. All right, Bellingham looking to set up their power play. And to the sideboard, Matt Alexander. Alexander now avoids a check by Hopkinton. And up the side it comes. Jason Robidoux can't handle it. Stumped to center and out it comes. Simos put some pressure on the puck, but now Bellingham comes in. Owen Haley now, the second leading goal scorer on the Blackhawks with 6. He wears number 14. Hard around the board, but not out. Rolf throwing up the sideboard. There's a shot that's blocked in front. Now Simos corrals it, and he keeps his feet moving and pushes the puck. He's defended by Colin Day. And Bellingham looks to mount a recharge. They get in the zone. Here's Haley. Haley loses the handle on the puck, but to the point and out it comes. Abbott puts some pressure on the puck now, and comes away, but he falls as he tried to avoid Alexander, but Simos now putting pressure on the puck. He ties it up. There's 20 seconds to go in the Bellingham power play, and Simos throws it behind the goal line, and Bellingham's having trouble now setting up their power play with 15 seconds to go. And the man advantage. 1-0's the score, the Blackhawks lead. And the Hillers will kill a penalty as Karpinski will come on the ice.
Yeah, it wasn't
the box.
It wasn't the prettiest of penalty kills, but they did the job.
There's a blocked shot by Dan Delaney. Doesn't get out of the zone. Now it does, and into the zone comes Delaney. Delaney avoids a check, shot and a save by Morris. Got his pad down low. Owen Delaney put a nice low shot down. Morgan tries to pinch in. He keeps it in still momentarily. They'll escape it in. Lindquist dumps a backhander and it rolls into the corner. And there is a whistle. I guess the referee. Yep, there is a penalty against Bellingham.
I remember when they used to give hand signals, Mike, that we could figure it out.
Well, this is a 4-minute penalty to the Blackhawks. There's a wrister for Rolf, a glove save by Morris. So
what gets you 4 minutes, Michael?
You know, I didn't see the signal, and now the referee's going to explain. And whatever the call was, it had to be egregious for the referee to give 4 total minutes. So the Hopkinton will now have a power play for 4 minutes. It's their first of the game. And now Rolf will set a rolling puck up. He throws it up the board. No one's there, and it's going to be icing against Hopkinton. Oh, no, I guess it's waved off. They felt Dulac could play the puck, I guess. I don't know how they missed that. Another one skating by him. Karpinski now comes down the pinch. He's checked. Simos with the puck. Simos in front is a shot wide, and it goes through the crease on the second chance. Dulac tries to get it down the length of the ice, and he does. In pressing on it, though, is Sean Williamson. Williamson now puts some pressure on the Hillers, but out of the zone comes Rolf. Everett Rolf gets to the blue line. Rolf avoids the man, looking to set somebody up. He's got a rolling puck. Now he settles it. Now Rolf goes back to the point. Karpinski takes a shot, and it goes into the netting off of a Bellingham stick. With 2:56 to go in the power play and 6 minutes and 11 seconds to go in the first period, Hopkinton trailing 1-0. Right. Owen Delaney in the circle. He wins it. Up to the point. Pickens takes a shot and a goal! From the point, it's a power play goal, and the Hillers tie the score at 1. Well, that was a low shot. That thing didn't go more than, like, I'd say 4 or 5 inches off the ice, which is exactly the way you want a defenseman to shoot the puck. And it went by the right pad of Morse, and the Hillers tie it up. And they will continue to be able to score goals, I believe. Let's check this out. Yeah, they're allowed to score as many goals with 4 minutes. So it's still 5-on-4. The power play still intact for the Hillers. Well, let's check this out a minute. Yep. The Hillers win the faceoff. Lindquist now trying to settle a rolling puck, and he throws it in the corner now to get it. Back to get it for Bellingham is number 31, and I don't have a 31 in my score sheet. Or is that a 21? Check that. It's a 21. Kyle Costello for Bellingham. All right, Hillers trying to set up their power play. They can't, and Bellingham will clear it. They've already got a power play goal here. It's a 4-minute penalty to Colin Day. Volke couldn't catch the pass, and neither could Billy Allen. And now the Hillers will change defense as Bellingham will get some momentum and get out of the zone. They launch it down with 2 minutes in the power play for Hopkinton. Rolf has Volke. Volke now called for the puck, but he didn't catch it. And so into the zone come the Blackhawks. And the Blackhawks like to check, Mike. And they always have as a team.
Yeah, I've always seen a very, very physical game here when Bellingham comes to Maverick.
All right, here's Karpinski, and they are having problems now connecting on passes, although Bellingham turns it over. And he'll just dump it in as they're going to change the power play unit. There's a minute and 30 to go in the power play for Hopkinton. It was a 4-minute penalty to the Blackhawks. Hillers trying to set it up. 4 minutes and 30 seconds. The Hillers trying to break in. They can't. Simos threw it off of a Bellingham play. Good kill by Bellingham now. And now there's a minute left. So they're killing about 2.5 minutes of this power play. And here's Simos. Steven Simos, the freshman. Good pass to Abbott, who swings and misses at the puck. I don't think he realized he was wide open. Now Finlayson comes down on the board. He gathers it, avoids a check. But now Simos comes away. In front shot and a save. And Morse puts a glove on it. And there's a little bit of extra stuff as the whistle blew. And Finlayson got checked from behind, it looked like. Steven Simos made a comment. Face-off with 40 seconds on the Hiller power play, won by Hopkinton. To the point, Karpinski. Cross ice, it goes to Rolf. Rolf to the circle, takes a shot, and it's a save. Now back to the point, and it skids by Rolf, and it goes deep. Rolf puts on the brakes, turns a backhander up. Now here comes Hopkinton. Karpinski, the senior. Gets on the blue line, tries to throw a pass in front. He does. He has a good pass. It's loose in front, and it's a save by Morse. And 10 seconds to go on the power play for Hopkinton. That's going to do it. Bellingham's going to kill off a good portion of the 4-minute penalty. And Hopkins is going to get called for icing the puck as they tried to hit a last second chance there. And so the faceoff will come down into the Hiller zone. 3:10 to go, first period. Hopkins and the Blackhawks are tied at one. Bellingham with their 4-1 record on the season. Let's check that 4-2. Hopkinton at 6-1. The Hillers with 12 points so far this season. And a faceoff. Some referees now delaying the drop. It finally goes down, and Bellingham tried to move it forward, but Lindquist now, and he tried to back in. He overskated the puck. Pickens now throws it on the board to Koshev. Koshev on his feet, throws it back behind the goal. There to get it is Coveney. Looks like Coveney is playing defense, if that is Coveney. That's his number anyway. Into the zone comes Lindquist. He's by himself. He's being chased, though, by Kyle Robitaille. And Koshev throws it to Lindquist. It goes off his stick. But Lindquist comes away with it now. He looks to set up. There's nobody in front. Now Koshev gets in the middle. And it's dumped to center and down the length of the ice, and it will be icing against Bellingham. 2:32 to go, the first period. Hillers, Blackhawks, Wednesday night hockey here at the Navin Arena in Marlboro, Mass. Mike Prate with Mike Terosian.
Saying a few words once in a while, filling in for the stuck in traffic, Rick DeSena.
And here's Temple now in the circle, Nick Temple. And Hopkinton's Vokey comes away to Temple. Check that. That's Owen Delaney. But Bellingham comes out with it. Well, there's a little bit of a hook that the Hopkinton got away with. But Delaney steals it. Here's a pass in front to Temple. Temple just had it go off the inside of his stick. Couldn't control it. Dan Delaney throws it down to the corner now. And behind it is Temple. Temple with some good speed now, putting pressure on the puck. Bellingham again, Mike, having some trouble getting it out. And that Hiller speed really has been the story so far this season.
Tell you, Bellingham did better on the defending the power play.
Yeah. And here's Dylan Boucher, throws it to the middle. And now Bellingham's trying to sneak a person in, but they're way offside. And it'll be an icing call, I believe, against Bellingham. The Hillers increased their power play goals on the season. They were 2-for-7, and then they just added one here, so they're now 3-for-8 on the power play. And that's how the Hillers tied it up. Bellingham took a 1-0 lead on a puck that I'm sure Dylan O'Leary thought he should have had. Boy, the referees just keep on talking, and they need another player, and I think Abbott's going off because I don't think he has his mouth guard in. Is that what the referee signaled? I'm not sure. Face off. Alex Koshev comes off, and now because of that, Finlayson will get changed, but Simos will win a face off anyway. Oh, Finlayson has it, goes off his skate. He couldn't corral it. And Hillers try to keep it in, but the Blackhawks get it out. But a nice kick with the skate by Koshev, and Bellingham's offsides. He doesn't believe he's offside, Robitaille, but I'm on the blue line, and he's got both feet over the blue line easily. He's shaking his head no. It's all a face-off outside the Hiller zone with a minute and 32 to go. Hopkinton loses the handle on it a bit. So Bellingham dumps it in. And here's O'Leary now. Oh, it's a turnover at the, and a save by O'Leary as he had to reach out with a glove. Well, a turnover at the circle cost Hopkinton, and a shot on goal.
Yeah, we see a lot of that last year, these little turnovers in front of the goal.
All right, faceoff won by Bellingham, but they lose the handle now. Abbott comes in and he's offside, or he drags Simos offsides. And Bellingham's going to change a couple of players. Kyle Costello comes on along with Matt Alexander. A couple of defensemen. And face off won by Bellingham. Bellingham gets in, they dump it in, but Delaney is there to knock it down. Connor. There's a tie up on the board, and Finlayson tried to spring himself off the sideboard. Nice idea. And Bellingham still keeps in the bouncing puck on goal, and it goes in!
Wow.
It bounces off O'Leary after it bounced off the ice a couple of times, and it went right
dribbled,
over.
Dribbled right in, Mike.
I think he kind of took it a little too nonchalantly there, and instead of getting fully square in front of it, it just bounced over. It was a tough play, no question. But another one of those goals where you throw it on goal, and with 48 seconds to go, Bellingham in the first period takes a two to one lead. Well, they haven't been the prettiest goals for Bellingham, but they do have a lead now. And the Hillers trail now. Nick Dulock now gets into the Hiller side of the ice. Karpinski tries to throw it out too late. And one of the Blackhawks dropped their stick. Koshev now tries to keep the puck in. It's kept in by Karpinski. He swings and misses at the puck. Now it goes to Koshev. Koshev throws it in front. Tip backhand tries wide. Allen tries to settle it, but another rolling puck. It's kind of weird, Mike. There's been a lot of rolling pucks so far in this third period. Well, 48 seconds to go in the first period. Bellingham takes a 2-1 lead. And we are going to be back with second half action. Second half action, did I say?
Yeah, it's not
second
basketball.
Period action.
Yeah.
In just a moment. All right, we get ready for second period action with the Hillers trailing 2-1. And the scoring went as follows. At 10:41, Bellingham got on the board first. And when they got what would be a pair of goals that they have scored in that first period that had some pretty bad bounces for Hopkinton. And that first goal was scored by Jason Robidoux, and he was assisted by Kyle Robitaille.
That's the one that looked like it just dribbled right in more than anything.
And Hopkinton answered a power play goal with Pickens, Will Pickens. And Will, he picks up his first goal of the season. And he had assists on the play by Owen Delaney and Matt Lindquist. But then with 48 seconds to go in the first, another bouncing puck got by O'Leary. And that goal was scored by Kyle Holland with assists by Matt Alexander and Owen Haley. And that's where we stand, 2-1. All right, Hopkinton now. Starts the second period going from right to left. They dump it in. And there to get it is Alexander. He throws it up off the board. He tries to hit Boucher. Boucher can't get out. It's a turnover. Now a squared up shot and a goal! Right away, Cam Finlayson scores, and the Hillers have tied it at 2.
That's how they get it started.
Well, 21 seconds into the period, Finlayson ties the score. And good hard work by the Hiller forechecking there, ties the score.
Forechecking and the speed. Getting to that puck first.
And the Hillers, whatever they drew up in the locker room, the coaches look like geniuses. All right. And they win another faceoff. They dump it in deep. Costello has it go by him. Delaney throws it in front. Now it's tried to be chipped out, and it will come out. Bellingham is trying to sneak the person in, and here comes a shot, and it's a puck that I think O'Leary got a piece of. Hopkinton's looking at the puck. They're not going after it there. Now they finally do. Bellingham comes away with it as they chip it in. Bellingham looking to throw it in front, and it goes off the Hiller leg. It's still loose. It's still on the ice. Still loose. Now Hopkinton throws it hard around the board, but not out. Kept in and towards the goal. It goes wide. Back to get it now for Bellingham. Costello takes a shot. Goes wide also. Hopkinton having trouble getting to the puck here. And there, Vokey now chips it, and it does not bounce out. Vokey does chips it out anyway. Bellingham is offside. Now they check up. Oh, there's a whistle. Bellingham didn't get back over the blue line. So with 13:44 and a stoppage of play here in the second period, Hillers have now tied the game at two. They're up against the 4-2 Bellingham Blackhawks. Hopkinton comes in with a 6-1 record. And down the length of the ice as it rolls, and it won't be icing because Delaney did not want to take a chance. Good play by Connor. If it didn't reach it, Bellingham was going to have the puck. So it's a smart play. Rolling puck to center. Intercepted by Saporosius. Saporosius now throws it in. The Hillers are offside. Koshev fell, and he fell into the zone. He needs to get back onside. And there's a body check and a huge, heavy check by Delaney. There's Delaney at the blue line. Shot, and it's a stick save by Morris as it goes up against the glass. Hopkinton has it. Karpinski throws it. It's blocked in front. Karpinski swings and misses, and Bellingham's going to launch it down the length of the ice for an icing. .12:54 to go in the second period. The score is tied at two. Finlayson in the circle. Wins the draw. But it goes to the blue line. It's intercepted by Kyle Holland. Holland dumps a bouncing puck in. Coveney now has it go through his stick, but it's hammered around as Steven Simos collects it. Simos up ice. It hits Abbott in the stick, and there's a nice stick move there by both players as there. Hills are starting to get a little physical here now too. Finlayson has it at the circle, looking up. He's got his head up, looking up, throws it in front, but it's only Bellingham there. Hopkinton's Coveney keeps it in. Coveney chips it in front. Here's Abbott, makes a move, loses the handle, slap shot from the point, goes over the net. The Simos put it right up on top of the goal. Good forecheck by the Hillers. Simos now to Finlayson. He falls down. Mike, I don't know if you noticed, but does it seem like a lot of players are falling down?
You're absolutely right. And I'm not going to say anything because I'm no Zamboni driver, but I did notice the Zamboni driver did not finish properly and had to make a little U-turn at the end. I have no idea. Other than that, one thing that I did notice, it is not the pond that it usually is to the start of the period. So I'm sure the ice is plenty cold enough. I don't know how smooth it is. I mean, it's no luring.
Now, it's so funny, though, that the old joke was when a player falls down in hockey, the ice is really slippery. All right, face-off win by the Hills. Rolf throws it back into the corner now. Allen comes down, throws it on goal, and is saved by Morris. And Morris has had to make a couple of good saves here now in the last 30 seconds or so. And another face-off inside the Bellingham zone. Matt Lindquist in there, the sophomore. And Bellingham wins it. They come away with it. Here's Dulac now. You got to watch him. He's got 9 goals on the season for the Blackhawks. Good check. Dulac throws it in front from the point. A shot, and it's a stick down. Actually, it was knocked down by a Bellingham stick. And it never got to the goal. Lindquist now gets in. Avoids the check. He has it on his stick. Throws it in front. It's on the goal line. Back of wraparound try. In front. Oh, the tip that goes wide. And now Morris will cover it up. As Volke and Lindquist were going hard towards the net. .11:06 to go in period number two. The Hillers leading. Are tied 2-2. They have scored a goal here early, 21 seconds into the second, and they've tied it up. Bouncing puck behind the net. Saporosius goes and chases with Robitaille. It goes on the sideboard. Now Saporosius comes away. Backhander is on goal to save. Now it's loose in front. Shot goes towards the goal. Karpinski now comes to rub his man into the board, and he does. And the Hills will dump it back in. Matt Alexander looking for a man. They're trying to spring somebody up ice, and they do. Into the zone, Chris Cullman. Cullman throws it on goal and a save. There's another shot and a glove save by O'Leary. And it'll be a face-off inside the Hiller zone with 10:26 to go in the second period. The Hillers and the Blackhawks tied at two. Face-off won by Hopkinton. I'll tell you one other area of improvement this team has, and that is winning face-offs. Simos, oh, he tried to slip one to Abney, just missed him. Well, it was a nice, pretty backhand. Well, Hiller's in a two-on-two battle on the boards. Simos and Abbott. Abbott comes away with it. He gets a stick chopped and goes up ice. Delaney there to get it. Gains the red line, dumps it hard back in. Dan Delaney, solid senior defenseman for the Hillers. Up to the point, bounces over the stick of Pickens, and he can't corral it. But he gets back and hustles back on defense, and so do a bunch of Hillers. Abbott to Simos. Simos stops it. He gets to the blue line. Simos looks up, throws a shot on goal. It's a stick save by Morse. Puck is rolling. Finlayson gets back, takes a shot, goes over the net. Delaney comes down and pinches. He throws it towards the sideboard, and it's out. It comes. There's that player trying to pinch, and that's Dulac. And the Hillers get in the zone. Abbott now flips it up in the air, hits the top of the netting in the roof, and stops play. 9:17 to go. Sorry, Mike, go ahead.
With Dulac's speed and with him being out in front that fast, you can see why he's got 9 goals already.
Yeah, if you're a Hopkinton defender, you've got to watch him when he's on the ice. If he's going to hang, you better have somebody back with him. All right, 9:17 to go, second period. Score tied at 2. Up the board. Owen Delaney with it. Pinches down. Rolf takes a shot, and it's a blocker save into the corner. Now Vokey. Vokey looking up, tries to turn around, and a shot. A backhand goal by Matt Lindquist. It looked to me like Lindquist was out in front and threw a backhander after the initial shot, and the Hillers take a 3-2 lead. Well, if it is Lindquist, he has goal number 4. In regards for Hopkinton, though, it's the third goal, and they take a lead here with 8:55 to go in the second period. Here's Vokey now. He misses, handles, couldn't get to it. Oh, there's another slip. Vokey now looking up ice. Hits Lindquist. Now it goes under his stick. Lindquist is bottled up, but he puts the pressure on the puck. Alexander and Lindquist go into the boards. Lindquist is going to get called for a penalty on a dangerous hit. And there's an extra hit there at the end. And some extracurricular activities now, and a shove to the face. And into the penalty box goes Lindquist. And joining him for the extra hit is Bailey Laughlin. Because he, after the referee had called the initial penalty, a cross check to Haley. And
maybe some more.
Yeah, they're going to have to put another person in the penalty box to serve Lindquist, who I believe is getting a boarding penalty. Going to put 1:30 on the clock, and it will not be a power play. And let's check it out here. It should be 5-on-5. Well, Bellingham had a chance for a power play there, Mike, and then the extra cross check after the fact. I don't think Lindquist deliberately tried to board the guy. It was just too dangerous of a hit. It wasn't an on-purpose hit. But Bailey Laughlin took exception to it, the senior, and he cross-checked. And so now it'll be 5-on-5 hockey.
And they're going to move it down to hockey or something.
Yeah, they should.
Mm-hmm. So we get a 4-minute major on the Hopkinton.
Yeah, and then so that will mean
So it's a power play.
Bellingham will have a power play. And they can score as many goals as they can in 4 minutes. There's a trip. Oh, the referee put the whistle up to his mouth. But he decided to no call it. And the far referee looked like he was going to the whistle after that trip. And he decided against it. All right, Killers are trying to get it out, and they do. Good effort by Simos as he was all over the puck. And Bellingham is offside as they touch the puck. Costello could not get over, the senior defenseman. And so the Hills will change a couple of penalty killers, up front penalty killers. Actually, they're going to change all four killers now. And the Hillers defending the power play have been 15 for 18 so far in the year, Mike. So it's a pretty good number. They've only
that
given up
a great number.
Three power play goals. There's a shot by a blocker down by O'Leary. Got up on it. There's a shot and another save, and there's a goal. A putback goal by Dulac, and he has his 10th goal of the season, and he has tied the game. Well, he was on the doorstep.
He was there. He was looking for that one.
And he pummeled it in off the initial rebound, and the game is tied at 3. And Bellingham will still be at the man advantage. Face-off launched all the way down. Karpinski hammers it around the board, but he can't get it out. Bellingham keeps it, but a good check now. Bellingham trying to set up their power play. Didn't have a lot of success, but they did just score a power play goal in the setup. Here's a break-in now for the Hillers. Oh, and just missing it is Abbott on the shorthanded try. Up ice, but it's intercepted by Simos. He knows to wait for Abbott to get back onside. Now Simos puts pressure on the puck, and it'll be a 3-on-3. But the Hillers, Pickens now has it, and he throws it down the length of ice, avoiding the ref. 2 minutes and 45 seconds to go in the Bellingham power play. They have already scored a goal here. Abbott puts some nice pressure on the puck. The Hillers now keeping the Blackhawks in their zone. A turnover. Abbott takes a shot and a save. It's actually blocked in front by a defenseman. He gets it on the glove. He felt that. Dulac. Cross ice it goes now. Bellingham breaks in. Simos comes back and defends. The puck is thrown down the length of the ice. And there's 2 minutes and 10 seconds to go in the power play for the Blackhawks. They've already scored a power play goal here. They've tied it at 3. And looking to add more. Bouncing puck. Hillers have a 3-on-2. Now they get back 3-on-3. Good back check by Delaney. Owen Delaney picked up his man, so he couldn't control the puck. Bellingham tries to launch it down, but there to get it was Delaney again. Owen puts pressure on the puck. 1 minute and 40 seconds to go in the power play. Finlayson comes down. He just overskates it a little bit, but the Hillers are there to meet it, but they don't get it in deep. And now Matt Alexander gets to the red line. He dumps it in hard around the board. There to get it is Rolf. Rolf pins it. He is checked hard into the board. Allen now mishandles the puck. And he gets it, and he throws it hard off the board, but not out. It's loose in front, in the circle, rather. Bellingham putting some pressure now on 1:10 to go in the power play. Hopkinton in the box on defense. There's a shot. It goes way wide and way high off the glass. And Rolf now does the nice job and throws it down the length of the ice. The goaltender, Josh Morse, keeps it. Bellingham trying to get up ice again. Williamson now, he has it taken away by Abbott. The Hills have had to kill a 4 minute power play here. I should say kill, they've already given up a goal on it, but again, like Bellingham, Hopkinton scored early in a 4 minute power play, and then Bellingham did the rest, but same thing with the Hillers. There's a shorthanded rush up ice. Karpinski has it now with 20 seconds to go. So I guess, Mike, what I was trying to say is both teams had four-minute power plays. Both teams scored early in their power plays. And then the defense did the rest. And Hopkinton looks like they're going to do the same. There's 5 seconds to go in the kill. And that's going to do it. Out of the box comes Lindquist. He steps on. And the shot is blocked. Oh, Morse has trouble with it as it took a wicked different direction there. And both players are coming out of the box. And so, 5-on-5 action with 4:21 to go in the second period. The Hillers and the Blackhawks of Bellingham tied at 3. Another faceoff won by the Hillers. Karpinski shot and a save by Morris. Bouncing puck that's still on the ice. Now, Zaporozhets, a backhanded win on the stick of Morris, and he chipped it out. And the Hillers take it back. Karpinski avoids the check. Takes a shot, goes over the net. Now Delaney. Delaney to Zaporozhets. He missed him. And another bouncing puck goes underneath the Hillers. But they are putting some nice pressure on. Now Bellingham chips it, and they get a steal. Delaney now throws it hard around the boards. There to get it is Koshev. Koshev does a nice tip job. Here's Zaporozhets. Nikolai Zaporozhets gets to the circle. Now he throws it in front. Oh, and he had Karpinski, who had his stick checked right at the last moment. Good play by one of the alternate captains, number 8, Bailey Laughlin. I think he got a stick there and prevented a glorious scoring chance. And Bellingham looking to set up. They just cannot get anything going. Zaporozhets putting some pressure on the puck. Laughlin now throws it up the board, but not out. Kept in. Oh, just missed Zaporozhets. Did Koshev. And Zaporozhets now looking to take a shot. And it's blocked down in front by Laughlin. It hit him in the wrist. Bailey Laughlin got that in his right wrist. Zaporozhets with it again. Looking up. Bellingham has packed it down a little bit tight here. 2 minutes and 50 seconds in the second. In front. And it's intercepted. And Coveney is there to corral it. And he throws it back in hard. And that shift really did a nice job, Mike.
A lot of work there.
They held the puck in the Bellingham zone. So here's Bellingham again trying to stretch the defense. Because they're not going to match Hopkinton's skating speed. And there's a whistle. There's the check into the net. Stops play. I was starting to say there, a team that typically can't skate with another team. Now here comes a penalty against the Hillers. And Spencer Coveney's going to go into the box. And Spencer Coveney decides to sit in the Bellingham box. Yeah. It's all right, as long as he's the only one in there.
Hey, you know what? I know what it's like to be on the wrong side.
Yeah.
Thank you to our wonderful host over there in Holliston.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's right. Here's a break-in now by Abbott. Abbott comes in, makes a move, and he takes a shot, and he misses it. Oh, he just had Morse beaten, and Abbott had a break-in on a shorthanded try, and he had the goaltender sprawled out, and he just couldn't elevate the puck. And Hopkinton had a glorious chance there with a 2:13 to go. Face-off win by Hopkinton, though. Goes underneath Allen's stick, but he gets it back. Now he throws it up ice, launches it down the length of the ice. The Hillers are killing another penalty here. I think a cross-check to Coveney. As he sits. And Bellingham trying to set up, but they are offside. Boy, that looked offside to me. There's a slap shot by Dulac. It's blocked in front, I think. And now down to get it is Williamson. Williamson throws it. Goes off the stick. And there'll be a face-off inside the Hiller zone with 49 seconds to go in the man advantage for Bellingham. A minute and 42 to go in period number 2 with the score tied at 3. Been a pretty exciting game, Mike.
It sure has. A lot of speed. Very physical game, too. This is one of the more physical ones that we've seen so far.
And the Hillers win the faceoff and launch it down. Morse now settles it. The senior goaltender, and all up ice it comes. Bellingham looking to make a rush here on the power play. They can't, though. Ill is defended. There's a shot that O'Leary gloves down and leaves. Now Hockington knocks it down. But that wasn't a high stick. Guess not. Now here's a break-in. Here's Delaney. Now Lindquist, rolling puck, takes a shot. Blocked down in front by Matt Alexander. There's another shot that's blocked in front. Now here's Dulac. He takes a shot and it goes over the net, hits glass. Williamson with the puck. And now Hopkinton can't get it out. They throw it to the wrong side, bouncing puck. That goes on goal. It's a save by O'Leary, who was there. And the penalty is over to the Hillers. Coveney jumps on now. And the Hillers almost get too many men on the ice there. They didn't wait for Coveney to clear. Abbott comes on now. And good pressure. Good pressure by the Hillers. Boy, wide open underneath the goal. And
wow, that one just rolled under a couple of defenders' legs.
skating down the right side was Finlayson. And I don't think the Hillers seen it. And so with 32 seconds to go in period number two, it's a face-off inside the Blackhawk zone. Face-off win. Horgan throws it across ice. He threw it on the blue line. It's a mistake, and it cost the Hillers. There's a shot and a save by O'Leary, and that's a big save. Yeah, one of the things you can't do is throw the puck on the blue line. It's a deadly combination. It ended up being a turnover, but O'Leary bailed his teammate out. And with 10 seconds to go in period number two, Bellingham looking to keep the pressure on Hopkinton, but the Hillers come away with it. They chip it out to center. Here's Finlayson. Finlayson's in with 1 second, and he's not going to get a shot off, and that's the second period comes to an end. Well, exciting action there. It was 2-1 after the first period, and after two now, it's 3-3, and we will be back with third period action in just a moment. All right, third period action is about to start with the Hillers and the Bellingham Blackhawks tied at 3, and the scoring in the second period was as follows. Hopkinton came right out of the locker room, and at 21 seconds in, got a goal from Cam Finlayson with assist by Simos and Abbott. And then the Hillers took the lead at the 9:01 mark, where Matt Lindquist scored, and which was his fourth goal of the season for Finlayson. That's his third. And then assist by Vokey and, let's see, can't read my own writing. Oh, Everett Rolf. And then Bellingham on a power play scored with Nick Dulac, who got his 10th goal of the season. And he was assisted by Matt Alexander and Sean Williamson. That's where we stand. The Hillers' shots on goal total that period were 14-6 for a total of 26-11 so far after two. Now the Hillers dump it in. They're skating from right to left, our left to right rather now. And face off inside the Bellingham zone. Hopkinton with their 6-1 record up against the Blackhawks, who are 4-2. And there's a shot that goes wide, but I think a piece of it was made by Morse. And now Bellingham will launch it down the length of the ice, and it'll be icing. So it'll be another face-off inside the Bellingham zone. We just started period number three. Hiller's next opponent, their next two opponents, will be at Medway on the 13th, so a week from tonight, and then a Westwood. So two tough games coming up, so you really would like to pick up a couple points. Backhanders, a shot is a save. Another pass in front, another shot, and goes wide. Still loose in front. Now Hopkinton comes away with it. Shot by Finlayson goes wide. Now Simos with it. Simos on the goal line, reverses now. Bellingham's there to get it. Rolf can't get there to rolling puck, and it should be icing once again against the Blackhawks. So anyway, Mike, I was starting to say, two of the tougher teams coming up for the Hillers. They're going to play next Wednesday against Medway, which is always tough.
Always tough.
and then Westwood on Saturday. So they're getting two of their toughest opponents back-to-back nights on the road. You go over to Westwood, that rink is small. Seems small to me, anyway. And Hopkinen doesn't fare well there often. There's a shot that's blocked down in front by a defenseman up front. Now the Hillers, check that, number 12. Holland comes across, and he blocks one. Hiller, if you look at the Blackhawks now, they've got about four guys deep. They do not want Hopkinen inside. And so there's a shot that's blocked down in front. And it's intercepted by the Hillers. Lindquist now at the circle. Throws a backhander on goal, and Morse will cover it against his body. Yeah, the pattern here for Bellingham, and actually when we saw Holliston the other night, Mike, was, you know, if you can't skate with somebody, you got to pack it in tight and hope you defend well. And that's what Bellingham's doing, because they just cannot match Hopkinen's speed to the puck. Now Pickens keeps it in. Shot goes off the backboard, and Volke tries a backhander in front. Lindquist comes down to help out. Now behind, Volke throws it up front. Pickens throws it down to Volke. Volke checks his man. But it's turned over, and Delaney throws it back into the corner. And Pickens, wrister, pad save by Morris, and he decides enough is enough as the pinball has been bouncing off of the backstop, back puck, glass, and him. And off the back of the netting also. So he stops play, and there'll be another faceoff inside the Bellingham zone. You flirt with a little danger, though, packing in like that, because pucks can go off extra people. There's a bouncing puck that's on the ice now. It comes down, and Bellingham tries to get out, but there to defend are the Hillers. Rolf throws at the center. Zaporosius chips it forward to Koshev, but right back out it comes. Zaporosius now with it. Nick to Billy Allen, throws across ice. A bouncing puck. Karpinski now tries a backhand towards the middle. Allen now chips it. Here's Zaporosius, turns around. Bouncing puck, and it's stopped by Morris as he covers. 12:30 to go in the game. Hillers and Blackhawks tied at 3. Couple of weird bounces enabled the Hillers, Blackhawks to score. And then a pure snipe shot by this man right here, Nick Dulac. He takes another shot, and O'Leary covers it. Nick Dulac, the senior, picked up his 10th goal of the season tonight against Hopkinton. Come in and take the faceoff. He's listed as a forward slash defenseman. I think he's one of these guys, you put him wherever you need him, and Hillers will win the faceoff. It'll bounce out. It's going to be icing if it makes the goal line, and it does. And so it'll be a faceoff inside the Hiller zone with 12:10 to go in the game. Right. Face off one by Hopkinton. They try to chip it out. They do get it out, but a nice keep by Robitaille as he dumps it back in. And now, Hillers with some speed. Cross ice it goes. Corrigan now tips it in. And Bellingham dumps the center, and they tip it in. Williamson to get it, but he doesn't get there in time. Now Abbott avoids the check. Abbott with some good speed. Throws it though, but not out. On the blue line, it's a turnover. Tipping, bouncing puck, still loose. And a couple of jab tries by Dulac, bidding for a second goal of the night. Well, a turnover again on the blue line. Almost cost the Hillers.
Right, and he almost lost the puck in front of the net where Bellingham was ready to swoop on it.
Well, the old, one of the hockey 101s is going in or coming out, you can't lose the puck on the blue line, in or out. Right. Bad things happen, and right there, Hillers tried a little bit of a sneak pass up the blue line, and it didn't work. And a backhand shot. Is it going to be a penalty? Nope, check that. It's off the netting, so whistle stops play. Now Bellingham now mounting some pressure on Hopkinton. They've had the puck inside the Hiller zone for a bit now, and faceoff won by them is a slap shot that goes wide from the point. Vokey now working over with Pickens. Pickens chips it to Vokey. Vokey can't control it now as it skidded by him. Dan Delaney now tries the other side. Goes over his brother's stick though. Tipped, bouncing puck. And Hopkinton is not skating at this moment. They're just having trouble now gathering the puck out. Vokey tries to chip it out and he does get it to center and Bellingham gets onside. Again, turnover at the neutral zone. Owen Healy gets it back now. Hopkinton now. Here's Owen Delaney. Owen avoids a check. Now the circle. He falls down. He tried Lindquist there. Lindquist throws it out in front. Here's Rolfe's shot. And a goal! Everett Rolfe hits a top roof of the goal and gives the Hillers a 4-3 lead. Oh, he got in the middle of the circles there, Mike, and he snapped one off, and it hit the roof of the net. And the Hillers take a 4-3 lead in for Everett. And that is his first goal of the season. Well, it was a nice sniped goal at the 10:23 mark. And the Hillers take the lead. Allen now, as the Hillers win another faceoff, throws it across ice. Hillers go chase. Saporosius now. Karpinski comes and helps out. Saporosius comes away to wide open in front. It's Koshev. Now there's a shot. Oh, it goes through the crease. He tried to hit Koshev, but he couldn't get enough on it. His Rolfe from the top of the circle. It's blocker down in front. I should say from the blue line. Dulac is hanging now, so you got to be careful. He's just skating around the blue line, hoping to get free. And Karpinski, cross ice to Allen. Allen, wrister on goal, goes through the crease. Rolfe comes down and get it. He keeps it in, but now it's a 2-on-1. But actually coming back to help out is Allen with good speed. Covers his man. And Williamson loses the handle. Rolfe does a nice job on defense there. And Koshev tips it to center and out it comes. 9:30 to go in the game. Hill is up now by a 4-3 score. Here's Dulac. He comes in, skates in by himself, takes a shot. It's blocked in front by Rolfe. And now Karpinski comes and helps out. Koshev cannot get to it. Now neither can Karpinski. Triple team against Bellingham. Cross ice it goes. He tried to hit. And Williams. Oh, and a save by O'Leary. As Williamson got a shot off, chipped out to center. And down to get it is Koshev putting pressure on the puck. He keeps it. And he throws it behind the goal line. Saporosius puts pressure on. And up the board it comes. And Delaney checks his man. And Koshev comes back and fills out and plays defense. Chipped up to center. Here's a chance for the Hillers. It's a good play by Morse as he paddled it out to keep a scoring chance from Finlayson. Williamson. No, still has it. Gets to the circle, takes a shot. A guy, whoa, wide open in front is Dulac. And a save. I think O'Leary got there as the net came off its mooring. Not sure if he got that, Mike. It looked like he did.
It's hard to tell from my angle, Mike.
Yeah, it looks like he got that. Boy, that was some play, though. Nice pass by Williamson. Dulac just hammered it. And O'Leary got a piece of it. Face-off win by Bellingham. And Pickens now gets a rolling puck, bounces behind the net. Pickens now with it. Pickens chips it off the board. Here to get it is Abbott. Abbott is checked. Simos comes and helps out. Now here's Pickens. Pickens looking to make a move. He has it. A shot and a goes over the net and hits glass by Finlayson. Up ice it comes. There to get it is Simos. He defends well. He's a defenseman playing forward. All right, Coveney now, who had been playing forward all season, but now he's a true defenseman like where he thinks he belongs. He had a good season playing up front, though. Here's Abbott. Abbott draws the Hillers offsides there. The Hillers have to check back up, and they do. And here is Simos. Simos avoids a check. Now Abbott has it on the stick. He loses. Simos now throws a backhand. If Bellingham knocks it down, they throw it up ice. But there to get it is Coveney. Spencer Coveney to Allen. Cross ice it goes. Here's Bellingham launches it hard, but they can't get it out. But they do now get it to center and out. 7 minutes, 5 seconds to go in the game. Hill is up by one. 4-3 is the score. And Hopkinton tries to get it out. Now Allen is in the clear. Billy Allen avoids the check. He's in, but he draws the extra move. Drew Delaney offsides. And he had to make that move because he was going to get clocked.
He was going to get in. Right.
If he didn't avoid it. It was a nice move by Billy. He just couldn't.
Was.
He couldn't.
Yeah. It would have been nicer if he was by himself.
Owen Delaney just couldn't hold the blue line to the last second. And there's Lindquist and Vokey. Lindquist and Vokey up front with Delaney on the wing. And Bellingham's Williamson backhands it towards the goal line. It comes out in front. There to get it is Allen. Well, I've said it before, and I've said it in the last few years, Billy Allen is a solid, solid defenseman. Does a lot of the right things. Hillers are offsides again. And Billy reads plays just as well as any player on this team. And he's a traditional stay-at-home defenseman. And that's how you, that's what you need, Mike, to win games.
That's right.
6:39 to go in the contest. Face-off won by Hopkinton. They dump it in. And back to get it for them is Bailey Laughlin. Laughlin now, one of the assistant captains and a senior defenseman. Allen comes down and pinches. He throws it down deep. Owen Delaney goes and puts pressure on. Now it's a turnover. Lindquist throws it behind the goal line. Not giving any to Bellingham any chance to get going. Here's a wraparound try, tipping try, and Morse decides to paddle it into his glove with his stick.
Yeah, that was a slow roller in front of his net. He had to go reach it for that.
6:09 to go. Third period, the Hillers leading 4-3. For these Blackhawks, and they are going to play Medway next Saturday, so they're going to have a tough match coming up themselves. And then Hillers will meet them in a week. Hillers get a break. A full week off after tonight. And try to improve their points total. They've got 12 on the season, does Hopkinton. And I was remarking, I don't remember in all the years I've been following Hopkinton hockey, a team that had this many points so early in the season. It's always been a struggle for the Hillers, but last year they can't take anything for granted. Remember, they had 19 total points last year. They needed one more. But their team speed has been a difference so far this season. Bellingham's offside. Now Delaney will launch it to the middle of the ice. And it's kind of sloppy play. Hillers don't want to give up any odd man rushes, so they're playing back. And smartly slow with a one goal lead. Now Karpinski throws it around, but only there to get it is Owen Haley. Haley chips it back to the backboard. And in front is a shot and a save by O'Leary. Point blank. Well, Hillers have kind of stopped skating here, Mike. Yeah. And they're giving Bellingham, when they do get out of the zone, a chance to score here. Coveney now a bouncing puck. Morse stick save. And Simos now puts pressure on the puck. Turnover. Finlayson makes it behind the back move. And he just mishandled it. Nice move by him. And Abbott throws it in, but Bellingham is there to meet it. Dulac is up ice. And they're looking for him. Williamson throws it on goal, bouncing puck, and O'Leary will cover it, and they want him to move it, but he won't. And so the whistle stops play with 4:08 to go here in the game. Hillers leading 4-3. And Everett Rolf shot from the middle of the circles has given the Hillers a lead. And Bellingham is going to call timeout as they want I believe they had this first unit out for a good portion of that last minute or so, and then they want to get a fresh set of legs here as they find themselves trailing 4-3. You're watching HCAM's coverage of Hopkinton High School hockey, and I'm Mike Prate with Mike Terosian. And if you'd like this or any other program, go to hcam.tv. You can purchase it. I believe the button now is not called Bring It Home. It's called
the HCAM Store.
The HCAM Store, right?
HCAM Store. You can still bring it home. You can just put in an order. You can get it by one game, by season. Many other shows, too, Michael. We have all the concerts from the high school and middle school for the winter. We had the two fall performances from the high school and middle school drama clubs. 42nd Street was done by the high school, and the original It All Starts Here was written by the drama students of the middle school for in honor of the Hopkins 300th anniversary.
So you can check it out at hcam.tv. All right, a face-off win for the Hill as Abbott tries to avoid a check. He gets it back, throws it hard around the boards. He tries to hit Simos. Simos corrals it. Now Finlayson takes a shot. It goes wide. Abbott backhander in front. Oh, and a nice pass and a goal by Steven Simos. Oh, what a nice pass by Abbott to Simos, and he roofed it, and Morse had no chance on that goal. So Steven Simos picks up his fifth goal of the season, and I'm pretty sure Will Abbott got an assist on that, his seventh, and the Hillers have now taken a two-goal lead with 3:52 to go in the contest. And that has taken a little bit of the sails out of Bellingham so far. But what a nice backhanded pass by Abbott. Pretty sure it was Abbott. My eyes aren't deceiving me. Here's Abbott again with the puck. Now he's looking for Finlayson, but he gets it taken away. Finlayson blockers the puck down. Bouncing puck that's corralled by Bellingham. They launch the center, and they try to get it out of the zone. Into the zone. They do chip it in, but right back out. Hopkinton dumps it. And Finlayson now, who's skating, and I've been pointing out this year offside, Abbott was over the blue line. And Finlayson brought in, but I was talking about Cam. He's really skating well this season. And they need him to stay on the ice all year because he is like a dynamo out there, both on the defensive side and the offensive side. All right, a face-off now. This ref is making sure that people stay lined up. You don't see that effort on a lot of refs.
Well, you see that kind of effort because they don't want to get in the middle of the scrum.
Rolf now tries to chip it out, but he can't. It goes into the hands of Dylan Boucher. Boucher backhands it in the corner. Rolf gets it back now. Rolf looking for a Hopkinton player, throws it off the glass, and I think it went into the netting for a stoppage of play. It did. 2:59 to go in the game. Hill is up 5-3. Couple of goals here in the third period. One by Rolf and one by Simos. And that's where we stand. Face-off won by Hopkinton. Boy, they win a lot. I'd love to know if someone's keeping that stat, and they do. I'm going to try to find it because they're winning a lot of face-offs now in this season. Bellingham tries to reverse here. Volpe pressures the puck. And he has it on his feet. Backhand try that I think got on goal as Morse had to use a stick to stop it. Rolling puck comes out of the zone. Back to help out is Lindquist. And another puck that goes into the net, and it'll be inside the Hiller zone with 2:30 in the game. And those are 2 minutes and 30 seconds away from having their 14th point of the season.
Bellingham's pulling their goalie.
Yeah, Morse will go to the bench to have a 6-on-5 attack, which is what you would do with down 2 or 1 goals. 2 goals, you do it more with about 2 minutes or so to go. 1 goal at about 1.5 minutes. It all depends, especially in high school level, where the faceoff occurs. Hillers cannot ice it, though, so. Now Coveney. And here comes Koshev. Koshev avoids the check. He has a slash, and there's going to be a penalty against Bellingham. There was a slash. And into the penalty box goes Dulac, as he had to, I think he had to slash him, because if he doesn't, I think Koshev will get a goal there and an empty net. All right, so the goaltender now, Morse, comes back in, and they'll pull a player. You can't take a chance of a face-off win with no goalie. And so into the box for a minute and 30 now. Bellingham will be shorthanded.
Maybe if you're down three goals.
Yeah. Swing and a miss by Penske. He got it out. Here's Simos. He's got a goal. Simos looking up. He throws across ice. Rolf, it's off the sideboard. Now he throws it down to the goal line. Finlayson tries to kick it to himself. He throws it to Simos. Simos at the circle. Oh, he tried to hit Abbott coming down the slot with a pass, but he just overshot him a bit. And now Abbott with pressure. Rolf has a bouncing puck go off him, and it's down the length of the ice. It's going to be a save by O'Leary, and he covers it not to take a chance with a minute and 27 to go. Smart play by him. 51 seconds to go in the power play for the Hillers. And now the goaltender, Morse, will come to the bench again, so it'll even things up. It'll be 5-on-5, but there will be an empty net. They're going to have too many men because there's a guy in the penalty box. Well, the referees don't like the fact that 10 came on before. And now he realizes he's made a mistake.
Yes.
And the reason the Blackhawks, oh, there's a shot on goal on the faceoff. 5-on-5 hockey. And Volpe up the center it comes. There's a dump in play. That's going to be icing against Hopkinton. Well, how it wasn't, I don't know. Didn't get the red line there. Didn't look like to me, but maybe it was. There's an empty net. Lindquist takes a shot. It's blocked in front. It's still loose. And down comes Allen. Allen, everybody's looking for the empty net, Mike.
Yeah.
50 seconds to
Who
go.
Doesn't want one of those?
Lindquist to Volpe. Volpe launches it down the ice, and he scores. He launched it from the circle here on the defensive zone, and it went fluttering in the air. And an empty net goal gives the Hillers a 6-3 lead with Volpe with an empty netter. And that is his 9th goal of the season. We're at the 46-second mark.
Is that the free throw equivalent?
Almost.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hopkinton now with 3 third period goals have iced this game. And Dulac is going to go to the penalty box. Oh, because he has to serve the full 130, I guess. I don't know why. All right, and there's a timeout. Timeout Hopkinton? Can't be Bellingham, I don't think.
Yeah, apologize for some of those words if you caught them from.
Hopkinton, a couple of Hopkinton students giving the Bellingham play. And that's wrong, really. The Hillers fans should just be quiet.
Pretty much.
And there's plenty of teacher presence here, which looks surprised.
Nowhere near the penalty box.
And you're right, Mike. We do apologize for a couple of those words that got over the air.
If they made it, unless I don't catch it.
I could hear it in my earphones. So, all right, here's a face-off center ice after the goal. The empty netter by Volpe. And a face-off won by the Hillers. Hopkinton is going to go on to win their seventh game of the season. And with one loss, 30 seconds of whistle, stops play as the hand pass against the Hillers. It'll be a face-off outside of the Bellingham zone. Actually, it'll be inside the Hiller zone with 31 seconds to go. Face-off win, and O'Leary covers. Well, this was a 7:30 start. It is 20 after 9. It's kind of long, a shot. And, oh, an initial save by O'Leary, and then a backhand that went wide with 20 seconds to go in the contest. And Temple now comes and gets it. Temple and O'Leary. Connor O'Leary. Connor Delaney. And with 9 seconds to go, another stoppage of play. And face-off win by Bellingham. Shots blocked by Koshev. And the shot saved by O'Leary. Up the board it comes. Another shot that goes wide, and that'll do it. So Hopkinton wins another one. They have won their seventh game against one loss. They have 14 points in their quest for 20 to make the tournament. And now they will take on two of the toughest teams in the TVL and in the state, for that matter, as they will meet next Wednesday on the 13th of January, Medway, and then that Saturday, the 16th, they will play Westwood, both on the road. And that's going to wrap up HKM's coverage of Hopkinton High School hockey, where, the final score is Hopkinton 6, and Bellingham 3. For Mike Tarosian, I'm Mike Prate. Thanks for watching, everybody.